Welcome back to Talk of the Town. Well, even if you don't have an ounce of creative talent, you can make a beautiful art piece for your Valentine. Carrie Ann Wood featured this easy idea on her Thistlewood Farms blog, and everybody loved it, and I love it too. I just think it's so much
fun. Thank you. It is fun.
And so easy, right?
Exactly.
If you can glue, if you can slap on a little paint.
Put some stickers on, you're good to go.
Yeah, super easy. Okay, let's show us how to do it.
Okay, so the first step is we want to start with a canvas.
Mm-hmm.
Canvases come in different size, different shapes.
I chose a square. At like a place like Walmart or Michaels or
Hobby Lobby.
Okay.
This is a 10 by 10 inch canvas, so nice, good size.
Okay.
You know, not overwhelming.
Right.
And I simply drew a heart on a piece of paper.
Anybody can do that, right?
And I went old school. And traced around it, yes.
Cut it in half.
Exactly, so it'd be exactly symmetrical.
Okay.
And then I placed it on the canvas and traced around it. Now the key is I did not completely trace the heart. I left a little, you'll see on the example piece here, I left a little bit of an opening.
So you're just going about halfway down on one side, just to make it a little more artsy, right?
Exactly.
And the toughest part is you've got to think up a phrase that you want to do in words.
That's right, and I would suggest a phrase between 29 and 36 letters is the perfect spacing for this size canvas and this size heart.
So something that means something to your Valentine.
Yes, and in our house, we always say, I love you, and then the person that says, I love you, the other person responds, I love you more.
Okay.
So this says, I love you more. Mm-hmm. But something else that we say in our house, too, is there was a book that I read to my kids the whole time they were growing up, I'll love you forever, I'll love you for always.
Mm-hmm.
And so today, as another example, we use that phrase.
Oh, that book always made me cry.
I know.
That's so good. What a sweet thing to do if you're making a Valentine gift for a child.
Yes. Or someone special in your life.
Yeah. Okay. All right, great. So we've got our heart traced, and then we're going to start adhering these letters. Tell us about these letters. What are they?
Now, these are actually stickers. You can find them at any craft store.
Okay, the like foam stickers?
They are foam stickers. Okay. And they come in a variety of fonts and different sizes. There's capitals. There's lowercase letters.
Okay.
So all you do is... It's really, really hard. Are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
What you do is you just take the sticker and you center it on the pencil marking and you just spell out your phrase.
Okay. And how far apart are you spacing them?
I just, with this particular one, I used about a pencil width between each letter.
Okay.
And then between the words, I used two pencils.
Okay. So I need an L, right?
That's right.
I should have figured this out ahead of time, right? Have we used up all of our letters?
I think there's an L
there's
right
an L.
there.
Okay, great. I mean, this is super simple because they're sticky on the back. And we're just going to put it centered.
Right. Kind of press it down to make sure it sticks. Because when you when
and
we
don't
go to
make
paint
it crooked. The good thing is it lifts back up, so you can't mess it up.
Yes. Good thing I never mess up. You know,
so. Me either. Not ever. All right. So you're going to space them out, and you keep doing this all the way around the heart. All right. So there you go. So it's going to go all the way around just like that. So once your letters are on and they're adhered really well, what's our next step?
Then you'll have something that looks like this. This is our finished canvas, which says, I'll love you forever. I'll love you for always.
Okay.
And then what we're going to do is we just take some simple acrylic craft paint. The key is the brush.
Okay.
We want to use a foam brush because we're going to have to kind of get down in between those letters.
Okay.
And you just start painting the letters.
Okay, so just dabbing it in there.
Mm-hmm. You just dab it in there.
Two coats?
I did one coat, and then after I finished the first coat, I actually took a paper towel, and I went and kind of dabbed the excess paint between the letters.
Okay.
Just to make sure that, you know, we didn't have, and you don't need to worry about your pencil line because we're going to cover it up with paint.
Okay, so after two coats, how do you make the letters kind of stand out?
Well, after I finished, I said, this looks amazing, but how can we make it look even a little more amazing?
Okay.
So what I did was I took a simple another foam brush like this with a different color. There was a darker gray, and then I came over here and I just kind of went like this across the top.
Okay.
And it really highlighted the letters, like our example.
And so this is the finished one right here. It's absolutely beautiful. I love this idea, Carrie Ann. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Happy Valentine's Day to you and your family. And if you'd like a link to this post, so you'll have all the instructions for it. I mean, it's super simple. You'll find that on our website. Also, you'll find more ideas on Carrie Ann's blog. It's thistlewoodfarms.com. Lots of inspiration, lots of fun, too. Thanks very much.
Thank you.